On this episode, we check out how I use my gear in real life. Yes, this is the mini IRL EDC edition where I put my gear to the test. So let's check it out. Oh boy, looks like it's all right.
Look, starting the day off as your own boss, one of the many perks is waking up at 11 a.m. Of course, still being completely out of it, this is often the first thing that happens. But that brings me to the first item of the day, my iPhone X in my mouse clarity case, keeping it safe in my drowsy state. First things first, current events, which means scrolling through Twitter and trying not to drop my iPhone onto my face. After finally getting myself out of bed though, it's time to unload and start the day fresh. And yeah, there's still a few more feeds to scroll through though. That is, if I can actually stay awake before having my coffee. Don't worry though, grimy bathroom tiles ain't got nothing on this case. So while brushing out my morning breath next, I'm checking the latest news articles on Feedly. Anyways, after my mouth is smelling fine AF, we get right back to ruining it with some coffee breath. And there's a reason why I drink mine's lukewarm. The fear of never knowing how hot the liquid is coming out of the cup always shocks me. It ain't even lunch yet, and this case has handled 3 servings of a smackdown. So checking around the case, the buttons have slits around it which allow for a softer click while still being raised to easily feel them out. I've got no complaints here. Large cutout for the meat rocker, and the camera cutout accommodates both the X and XS models, which of course is thick enough to keep it from licking your table. Cutouts along the bottom are large and can accommodate most cable sizes, but this case is all about, well, this, almost not being seen. The all clear back, no branding to get in the way, just a clear window to show off you sold your soul for this tiny bitten apple. Luckily, it's also designed to stay as clear as possible thanks to its scratch resistance. You can share this in the same pockets as your keys so long as you're not forcing them to make love together like this. No means no, kids. Better yet, if you're too poor to own keys, the case itself has a lip around the whole backside to keep it raised off any surface. So don't worry, this case has taken every precaution to try and stay invisible. In terms of grippiness, it's got a glossy finish throughout, and thankfully it doesn't add a lot of bulk. But there also isn't any added texture, so it can be slippery if you've got hands drier than a raisin. I do love they included their lowered bezel around the center so it doesn't get in the way of Tinder swiping, but they still raise it along the top and bottom for that optimal face planting prevention. If that's not enough though, pairing it with a hybrid glass screen protector will basically give you 360 degrees of coverage without the bulk of, well, 360 degrees of coverage. Plus, with their applicator guide, it makes it so easy that even the most uncoordinated of you out there can still do it. Yes, it's super thin, bubble free, and will take a grenade for your phone, metaphorically speaking. Now combine that with this goopy green stuff they call AeroShock, which we saw work miracles in my previous review, I can confidently say this green Play-Doh can actually, probably, maybe most likely take an actual grenade for your phone. It's that damn good. This case can withstand the toughest of drops or just silly ones throughout your day. So let's get to the office. During my day, a lot of my time goes to storyboarding and figuring out my edits before I even shoot, done digitally and analogically. So my go-to pen, the Bic 4-color grip pen. It writes on the thicker end, which I prefer when sketching, but also has 4 colored pens built into it, which of course makes for a great fidget toy when I'm working through a problem or just a great way to annoy your coworkers. The grip portion of the name isn't to be forgotten too, with a large rubber surface along the bottom half of the pen. It's very comfortable to use even during those long and thoughtful brainstorming sessions. Better yet, they've got a few different models too, like my second favorite one, the 3+1 pen and pencil combo. It does bring back some nightmarish memories of school, but drawing with a pencil does have its benefits, mainly being it can be erased, like with the one built into the top of the pen. So if you're going to buy a pencil anyways, why not have 3 pen colors built into a super comfortable grippy case too? Lastly, the 4-color pen with a stylus built in for those who can't afford an Apple Pencil, this'll do the trick. It's not super accurate, it feels sorta cheap, but it works to draw a quick masterpiece. It's hard to complain. Plus, with the clips on each of them, I can store it in my pocket for whenever someone asks me for an autograph, which, for the record, has never happened yet. So it's after lunch and I'm rushing out of a meeting. It's only right that the first thing my 2 left feet do is trip straight on the hardwood floor, but the case handles it like a champ. And of course, like any other day in the office, my next meeting is calling already. So I pop my earphones in that are, yes, attached to my damn wrist. These are the AI Power Wear Buds, and most surprisingly, they just sound really good for its size and what it costs. They're discreet and snug, even in my large right ear hole. I can rock pretty hard with these on, where my phone has fallen out of my hand before these have fallen out of my ears. Don't worry though, you know it's fine. Plus, when you're done, no fiddling around your pockets for a case, because it's on your gosh darned wrist. Like, What? That's really what you're buying though. A new concept that actually solves several problems in my life. So taking a closer look, the buds are quite tiny. Given that they have to fit on your wrist, they're about the size of a dime, but you'll still get a decent few hours of playback out of them. Plus, when you do need to charge them, it's a flick of the wrist away. It's got Bluetooth 5, IPX6 water resistance rating, and support for APTX, so they do promise quite a bit, but it doesn't even end there. The watch case itself has a heart rate monitor built in for its activity tracking capabilities. Everything is quite simple as they're starting from scratch, but I'm excited to see how it evolves given its very affordable price point. Now the downside to that though, everything does feel a little cheaper being made of plastic all around. But this is for those who want the ultimate convenience and tracking features all built into a single package without breaking the bank. Now after all my meetings, I like to go for a walk, maybe do some shooting outside, and during the summer, I gotta have a pair of sunglasses. So this is the Distill Union Maglock sunglasses in their aviator style for those extra cool points. What makes them special though? Well, this, the magnets built into the arms of the frame, so you can attach it to anything metallic or just anywhere you feel like too, safely and securely. Bonus points with the polarized lenses, they make a quick and dirty filter for your phone's camera. Just make sure you don't stare directly into the sun while doing so too. Back to the glasses, my favorite feature is how they're basically indestructible. Yeah. It's hammer time. I don't recommend you take your anger out on your glasses, but if one day you do decide to do so, just know you'll probably get angrier because your weak hands couldn't even break a pair of sunglasses, but then you'll also be super glad they didn't actually break. Now back at the office, generally working through an edit, but also mail time. That's when I pull out my favorite multi-tool to date, the new Leatherman Free T4. With its one-handed action, I can cut through any box pretending I'm a samurai with mail? The 2.2-inch 420HC blade slices through boxes like it's butter. This isn't a full-fledged multi-tool, only providing the essentials you'd need on a daily basis, like a flathead to tighten tripod plates, a great pair of scissors for some origami sessions, and a Phillips screwdriver to loosen all them damn GoPro screws. The best part, as fast as any tool is accessible, it's just as quick and easy to fold away one-handed too. It's not huge, but it comfortably fits in the palm of my hand while giving me just enough to hold onto while in use. It's kind of cute and definitely not as intimidating to use as their other tools. Plus, it utilizes quite a bit of plastic within the shell to lighten the load, but also helps align the tools properly since its second handy dandy feature is the built-in magnets. Every tool is accessible with just a thumb roll. You can quickly pick and choose your weapon of choice, or store it away just as fast and let the magnets keep everything securely in place. So I have my phone for all my digital tasks and my Leatherman T4 for the real world tasks. Oh, bonus points, it's even got mini tweezers too. Great for picking up really small foods or just for your bushy eyebrows. And yeah, the screw protector can handle that too. Overall, the size is what won me over though, as I don't have to worry about carrying a large chunk of metal around. And with the included clip, I slide it right into my pocket where it's arm's length away whenever I need it. Now during longer editing sessions, I like to head out to grab a snack. And today, some Whoopers will do just fine. Making sure I've got enough cash in my wallet of choice, the Chrome Industries Zip Wallet. This may look like a skater boy wallet, and that's because it mostly is. And I love it. It stores everything I need, and it's just convenient for my daily routine. In classic Chrome Industries fashion though, the wallet is made of a waterproof tarp on one side with a very classy logo embellishment, I might add. Then some tough nylon wrapped around the rest of the wallet and all secured together with a thick zipper running around three sides of it, which is mainly why I love it so much, giving you complete access to everything within. You can easily dig around it, seeing everything inside at once, and no matter how hard you fumble, nothing falls out. It's like a mini damn purse. So let's see what it can actually carry inside, and it definitely does add up. The wallet offers some organization with three sleeves and a zippered pouch, but it's mainly just a big damn pocket. So in the front sleeve, my quick access cards, behind that, cards I don't always use but need on me. Then the last pocket behind that is basically storage. Band-aids, condom, because safety first, coupons, receipts, coffee points, and even random things like a backup SD card. I've got my cash dead center as I'm constantly grabbing it, and even extras like this dude wipe because things can get messy. I store my change in the zippered pocket so it's not flying around. And my last item, the Pocket Tripod Pro. A super lightweight tripod that's made of plastic and carbon fiber that's only the size of a freaking credit card and not that much thicker too. It's very easy to set up, flipping and folding the pieces into place. They offer a range of adapter sizes to fit from no case to thicker cases, so squeezing mine into place, the tripod grips on like a clingy boyfriend. You just can't get rid of it even if you wanted to. The base can also be adjusted for a whole range of angles, which makes framing the perfect shot a breeze, and on flat surfaces, the tripod works wonders in keeping it from falling over. Better yet, you can even spin split the legs for an even more secure ride. But sometimes you can get a little too into the shot and forget how far off the edge you actually are, but the Mouse Clarity Case and Hybrid Screen Protector handles that 6-foot drop like a champ. Once you're done shooting though, everything clicks, folds, and snaps back into its credit card size shape. And that means I can fit a full-fledged phone tripod right in my wallet. Cha-ching. That's my wallet though. With everything packed, there's still plenty of space for more if need be. Plus, with that full zipper wraparound, it means everything stays secure. And look, I'm not blind. This is no minimalist fantasy. It's a big sucker, and you want to be careful when walking around other guys, as they may mistake that large bulge in your pocket for something else. To finish off my day though, after waking up, heading to the office, editing, snack time, and now back home, which is really the only key I carry. I store it in my Bellroy key cover in my front pocket with a quick flip and twist to access action. This all leather organizer is just fun to fidget with its magnet snaps and a soft texture all around. They are known for their leather products, and this guy cuts no corners in details too. It can fit up to 4 keys, and they've even got a plus model that can go up to 8 as well. But the whole idea is simple. Open it up and swing the key you want out, and kablam. Then just hide them all away so there's no protruding sharp edges out to tickle you. The built-in magnets keep the whole thing closed shut, but also makes for another great way to annoy your coworkers. For anything larger, I've got the KeySmart MagConnect, a tiny but very strong magnet that allows you to swing your car fob around without a problem, and then with a swift thrust, remove it when you don't need it. It's a simple piece of metal that won't break the bank and saves you from breaking any fingernails trying to remove things too. The loop on the key cover makes it easy to attach any clip of your choosing, but honestly, it's best when just used naked. The all leather and soft feeling in the hand is like holding your non-existent girlfriend's hand. But it's also just a safer option, as you can pop this in the same pocket as your phone. Although if you had the hybrid screen protector on, even without the key cover, you'd be fine. It's simple, elegant, and just does what it's intended to do, store my keys while still being easily accessible. And that's how I use my EDC in real life. Maglock aviator sunglasses for the cool pilot vibes, the new Wear Buds so I always have earphones with me, my Leatherman T4 that handles any daily tasks I throw at it, the zip wallet for all my essentials, safety first kids, the key cover to keep everything in one place, and of course, my bread and butter, my iPhone in the Mouse Clarity Case that keeps it safe throughout my hectic day. It's just a case I trust to handle whatever or wherever I throw it. That's it. Links and discount codes to everything down below. Let me know what your daily essential gear is. My day is done, so I'm just going to enjoy the Canadian views. I rest my case.